Yeah, so the first reason is Durham is home. So anytime I could get back closer to my mom is good. The biggest thing is having the ability to do the work and the research I want to do in an environment where it can thrive and it's supported from my chair to the dean to other colleagues. And so I felt like Duke was the perfect fit for me in this time. So my new class, race, gender, class, and computing, was something that I'd created probably about 3 semesters ago. But every time I talk to people, I tell them that that class was really born out of my own self-interest, dealing with bias and racism as a Black woman in higher ed, and especially in computing, where there's not a lot of Black women graduates, let alone PhDs and faculty. So if you see a lot of representation of diverse groups of individuals, then you don't consider all of the potential impacts of the technology you're creating. We see a lot now where things like facial recognition technology are wildly inaccurate for people with darker skin colors. Well, the people who were developing these technologies didn't consider that because no one in the room looked like them. And so to me, it was important for students, especially on that front end as computer science students, to start understanding as you're learning about algorithms and programming, let's also learn about how algorithms are negative depending on how they've been developed and depending on who they're impacting. And so once I realized that students aren't getting a lot of that information unless they take a higher level course that's focused on it, it really became important for me to put it all together in one class. Priorities at Duke, I would say first is getting this class up and running. I would love to grow that and make it a cornerstone of the computer science program, something that every student either wants to take or eventually has to take in order for requirements to be met for graduation. I'd love to grow my program in cultural competence such that it becomes a blueprint for other institutions, regardless of whether they are PWIs, HBCUs, HSIs, or tribal colleges, to understand how they can better teach and infuse cultural competence into their programs. So if I could say anything to women, girls, or anyone from a systemically marginalized group, I would say in order to be successful, first find your voice. Don't be afraid to use it. And also find individuals who will support you and the work you want to do. And last but not least, don't ever allow other people to make you believe anything about you. You know you better than anyone else. And so own your narrative and make sure that as you move through academia, through life, and everything else, that you are owning the narrative and not allowing others to define you based on what they believe.